because the day after the true story was printed in Liverpool, the paper was burnt on the streets. For a long while, as a working journalist, you couldn't really operate very easily in Liverpool because they'd just say, journalist, the Sun, liar, rotter, we're not going to work with you. And they wouldn't buy the paper. Some people bought it. It was more or less, you had to get it in a brown paper bag up there. It's the most effective consumer boycott that I can think of. Now, as a result of that, they were losing so much money, millions over the years, when you think of that lost circulation or lost advertising, that they tried to make it all up again, but it didn't work. So now they've gone to another strategy, apparently, of just simply denying everything. And that's, I mean, I think that that's even worse.
Do you think that's why they haven't put it on the front page today? Because I'm half expected another apology.
It's a disgrace, particularly for the Times, but certainly for the Sun. It's given up now any pretense of being a newspaper. The news of the day, whether it should be or whether it shouldn't be, whether there's more important things in the world or not, I don't know. But the news of the day, and you're journalists as well, as you know, what you do is you go in the morning, you read all the papers, and you find out what the agenda is for the day.
But newspapers do have their own agenda, of course, don't they? They're not like the BBC, where we are impartial, and they can put on what they want on the front page.
But you do have an agenda in the sense that, well, here's what's happening in Parliament, here's what's happening in courts, here's what's happening with all your pressure groups and your trade unions, your political party. And you sort through that and you say, well, what are we going to be doing today? And so all the rest of the media are talking about Hillsborough. It's on what we journalists technically call the news agenda. You've got your hidden agendas of your different papers and their different attitudes and everything. BBC says it's not, but other people don't, but there you are. But I don't mean that. I mean, this is just the professional thing that newsrooms do. What is the news of the day in the UK? Mm. And up there, number one, number two, is Hillsborough. And they have buried it. Now, if you do that, you're not a newspaper anymore. You're not in the news game. You're in the propaganda game. Mm. And obviously, why they want to bury this story is it directly affects the business interests of the publisher. So that is, by definition, not only not journalism, it is the opposite of journalism. Suppressing a story because it makes you look bad, terrible. We've had all these scandals over the years with the BBC as well.
Chris, I'm so sorry. We are going to have to leave it there. We've got a terribly busy morning on the traffic, but thank you ever so much for joining us. That's Chris Horry there.
Okay.
We have contacted The Sun for comment this morning. They have declined to talk to us, though.